Nowadays, augmented reality is one of the most popular production techniques. We achieve this when our digital content appears over the real world and composite it correctly. But it badly conceived by the viewer without accurate reflection and shadow. The following video tutorial elaborate the workflow based on Reality Engine. With the help of our deep integration with Unreal Engine, we can get additional shadow, reflection and bloom path without using any additional camera. That enable us to get hyper-realistic results with the help of our node-based compositor. These are some topics that we will going to cover in this video. Drag and drop AR Skylight component from the Place Actor tab. Drag HDR texture from asset browser while AR Skylight is selected and drop it onto cube map section under the details tab. Also set its mobility to movable. That's everything we need to set up in Reality Editor. Let's hit play and switch over the Reality Hub to start working on node-based compositing. Reality Engine projection. We already set up basic IO and tracking. Let's add projection cube node and camera node to the R graph. From the camera node, connect the track input to the tracking data. You can immediately see cube with different colors. Projection cube is actually a procedural mesh. It means we can make some real-time changes like enable or disable each side individually and also have full control over its transformation. You can even use your own custom mesh to receive projections. We will talk about this in our future videos. Let's add projection node. Connect track input to the track node and actor input to the projection mesh. And then connecting video input to video source. To compensate the exposure, we need to add post-process node and connect it to the post-process input of the camera node. By this way, we can control all post-process parameter in runtime. Please don't forget to connect track input pins on each node to the track node. Let's create one more camera and user track to observe the whole setup from another perspective. Let's add mixer node which enable us to see different passes and output in separate channels. Connect the camera that we have created at the beginning to channel 1 and connect the second camera to channel 2. To check another perspective output. Right now camera is at its origin. Click the small gamepad icon on user track. Go to the bottom right and click gamepad icon so that you will be able to change the position of the user track by moving your mouse and pressing QWEASD keys on the keyboard. We can see the composite out on channel 1 and at the same time in channel 2 we can see how projection works. Click the first camera node and click debug icon at top right. You will see the camera. Besides that, you can enable debug on projection node in order to get visual feedback and perform any modification. Track inputs that are connected to the camera track node and projection node are getting tracking data from the same tracking node. Let's check what happened when we move our studio physical camera. Projection node act like an optical projection device. From the physical projector's perspective, everything looks fine, but if we change our viewing angle, it distorts the projection. Let's check how overall setup behaves when we add a light. We can't see any difference even after changing light intensity and orientation. The projection is unaffected by the light because of the projection node material property. The current selection is masked material which is unlit. When we use the lit mask material, you will see the projection mesh is get affected by the light. We are able to see the shadows in real time when we change the light value. Let's see what's happened when we transform the position of the projection cube to forward. Please pay attention to the shadows as we move along. Let's reset its location to its original position, bringing the camera closer to wall to be able to comprehend more. Let's create a dummy cube and bring its position behind the AR object and the shadow deform accurately according to the mesh surface. Let's align the front surface of the dummy cube with wall and scale accordingly. Now right-click and create one more projection actor and connect the dummy cube. As soon as we connected the cube to the projection actor, you can see the projection is on the mesh. In short, projection node is a material. Projection cube is a surface that receives the projection. Reality engine projection reflection. You can use roughness and metallic parameter on the projection node when you want to have reflected projection surface. It's same as the reflected material in Unreal. What should we do to get reflection on any specific part of projection? Well, it's very easy. Select the projection cube node and from the reality visibility drop-down uncheck all faces except the bottom. Duplicate the cube and then check all the surfaces except bottom. We can still see the unwanted reflection around. Well, projection node is a material and any mesh connected to it will receive its properties. Duplicate projection node and connect the second projection cube to it. Now, in order to get rid on reflection from walls and roof, just bring metallic value to 0 on second projection node. Reality engine shadow casting. Let's talk about AR shadows. Let's create a spotlight and align it with the real light source. You can enable the debug mode in order to get its visual feedback in the scene. We have two spotlights in our studio. Let's create virtual spotlights and align them with the physical one. Don't forget to adjust their rotation. Let's exaggerate intensity, but there is still no shadow. The reason is the projection material is selected as masked. As I described earlier, we need to set the material as lit mask if we want to get projection affected by the light. Now we can see the light affecting the floor. Let's adjust inner cone angle and the outer cone angle parameter as per our requirement. Duplicate the spotlight and align it with the second physical light. There are the lights in the physical environment and we do not need to have extra lights. Setting intensity as default, which is 0.001. We can increase the intensity on projection if we want to make the environment brighter. Connecting camera out to channel 1 on mixer node. And shadow pin to channel 2 in order to see shadow pass on different channel. Check if render shadows on engine node is enabled. But still no shadows, right? Actually, we need to select the shadow channels from each light source. Select red for the first light and green for the second. Now we can see the shadows. Let's use channel viewer to see different shadow channels. Let's create a post-process material and connect to the post-process node in order to get better control over lights. Let's select reality shadow AO on post-process material. We can adjust red and green shadow channel intensity from post-process material. We can control shadow opacity, alpha, green, blue, and red channels under shadow category separately. Reality Engine Ambient Occlusion Mask. We may want to control ambient occlusion, or we don't want to have it on some specific areas. To do that, we can use parameter under AO mask category on post-process material. Set the alpha under debug category as 1 in order to see the areas that AO applied. Now we can see that ambient occlusion is applied as pink color. Increasing AO gamma to see AO intensity. Enable debug mode. Let's move ambient occlusion mask out of AR object using Y offset parameter. Let's disable debug mode. As you can see, there is no ambient occlusion out of mask, so that we can apply ambient occlusion on the desired areas. We can control ambient occlusion intensity using AO gamma and AO opacity under AO category. Reality Engine composite passes. Let's get started with the compositing. There are multiple ways to do this. Using merge node in R graph, using reality material in Unreal, and using composite passes node in R graph. Merge node and reality material is out of scope for this video, and we will look at them in future videos. Let's create composite passes node and connect camera out to its render, and track pin needs to be connected with the track node. Video input is connected with the video source. Now we can see AR objects and video source. Let's connect camera shadow pin to the lighting pin of composite passes. Shadows are on now. Let's play with AR object position and see how shadows are working. We can get shadow pass by selecting shadow channel of the light we have just created and control it.